dogs. We've got a,
have to sign a release.
I haven't come up with one yet.
Influencer.
The papaya. Making some breakfast this morning. Skip, friend of ours. Here's Tatiana. Going back to school in a few days, but taking full advantage of her culinary skills while she's here. Yeah, we're cooking sweet potatoes. Here's Natalie cutting up some honeydew lemon. Got a little.
Got my little spot here. Who needs a cutting board, right? Rinse it off. Nothing gets sticky.
Got it all right back there.
Oh my gosh,
what's that? There's our coconuts. Might be milking a few in a few minutes.
Look at that soul.
Here's Connie. I gotta learn how to do those massages for those rough days on the water. Oh, here's our mother, Veronica.
Cheers.
Happy New Year. Havana Club. Enjoying some rum. Beautiful day on the water. Here in Key West.
This boat here is referred to as a chug in the Keys, a small open boat made out of whatever material was at hand by Cubans trying to escape from Cuba. They're powered by anything they could find, such as car and tractor engines. Under the wet foot, dry foot policy, Cubans who made it to dry land or any U.S. port of entry were allowed to stay in the country and apply for permanent residency a year after they arrived. The risks were high, and many people drowned or got lost at sea, but others made the journey. These boats can be found around the Keys, which is the main landing point for many refugees. Obama ended the wet foot, dry foot policy in the last days of his presidency, which has led to fewer refugees attempting the trip.